Welcome to our special edition of Live Free. We're Gary and Drenda Keesee, and we're excited you're with us today.
Yes, today we're talking about, is it God's will to heal you? And Gary, is it God's will?
Absolutely, because trillions, thousands of dollars are spent every year by people that either have to stay home from work, lose work, buy prescriptions, doctor visits. It affects every family's budget by the tune of about $8,000 a year. If you're sick or not, at least $8,000 per person a year is essentially what they say averages out, the $1.1 trillion that it adds up to in the U.S. for healthcare and consequences of being sick. Tremendous amount
yes,
of money.
It is a tremendous amount of money.
Yes.
And if you struggle with sickness or disease, you know not only does it affect your pocketbook,
yep. It
affects your life in every area, your outlook, and whatever you do, you're debilitated by this sickness and this disease.
Yes.
And God doesn't want you to live that way anymore.
That's right. And we got some great guests on the show today that are going to tell how their life was changed when God
yes. Healed
them and allowed them to go back to a normal life, prospering and healthy. Today, you'll find the answers.
On Live Free.
Tonight, infections are spiking. The country under lockdown for the
developing treatments in the back.
We announced that this is a global pandemic.
People need to see the power of God in this generation. They need to see not the religious God, they need to see the power of God.
That spirit of infirmity that is killing people through a virus is demonic. I believe that this is the hour for the church to rise up with the authority given to it to deal with situations just like this.
Life and death is in your tongue, and God has given you more authority over them than anyone else.
All the benefits of the kingdom are legally yours. You have the absolute authority in this thing.
God wants to bring wholeness to your life. We've got a couple of great stories today, testimonies of those that were healed. And the first one, this person was facing possible diabetes their whole life, panic attacks, fear, having to eat a restricted diet, and just overall paralysis, just dysfunction. And that person was you, Gary, right?
That's right. It was. And it was dysfunction, and
it was
horrible.
This was about how many years ago?
Oh, my. This was probably
20 years ago,
I suppose.
20 years ago, that's what I was thinking.
And so it was pretty rough.
And what was going on with you at that time in your symptoms?
Well, we were financially not doing well. We were in great debt and sales. And so the fear of living each day, money problems. 50% of all bankruptcies are caused from medical problems and vice versa. Medical problems are caused by stress through the financial problems, okay? And you've heard divorces, 50% are caused by finances.
80%.
That's right. 80%, yeah. But bottom line is finances bring fear, okay? A lot of people are under stress in their finances.
Worried about money, worried about
yeah, and so what that did
bills.
For me is we had, 10 maxed out credit cards, 3 finance company loans. We were behind on everything, judgments and liens. We went through trash piles trying to find stuff for the house. I mean, we pawn shops.
I mean, I don't mean to discourage you, I remember this taste,
but you know
no,
what I'm talking
it
about.
It actually makes me grateful to
yes,
see what God has done to transform
yeah,
that.
Yeah, but back then, of course, it was stress. And
very much.
I just was under fear and great pressure, not really knowing the kingdom at all, not knowing. We were believers, but we didn't have a concept of the kingdom.
We knew about the kingdom in general, but we did not actually get in there ourselves.
Didn't really
have a lot of people live in that place.
Revelation,
they acknowledge
yeah.
God, they hear a sermon on the weekend, but we weren't actually pursuing it with all our heart.
I didn't really understand what the term kingdom meant back then. Mm-hmm. You know, I knew about God, but I didn't know about kingdom. You know,
nor did we know how to enforce our authority. We didn't know really a lot of scripture about healing. We knew it was God's will to heal, but not in here.
So, yeah, it was all hypothetical theory, Bible. It wasn't real to me at that time.
Right.
But it was real very quickly when I woke up one morning and I was paralyzed and been a very stressful month and people calling creditors. Woke up in the morning, my tongue was paralyzed, my arms were numb, my legs were numb, I had heart palpitations, panic attacks. I was totally thrown off guard and scared spitless because I didn't know what this was all in my
body.
How
much do you think fear has to do with sickness?
Oh, fear had a lot to do with in that case, a lot. Fear has a lot to do with sickness. It's the door opener. Fear opens the door. Spirit of infirmity walks through it. And in my case, spirit of infirmity walked through it. Mm-hmm. And that's how I got myself messed up. Now, when I woke up and found myself paralyzed, I remember, you know, I began to pray and ask the Lord about it. And He woke you up. We began to pray. And God began to speak to me. But I was very, very weak in my faith. I didn't know who I was in Christ. And so we went to doctors. They couldn't find out anything was wrong with me. They said I had sugar imbalances. I'd be diabetic. And they said, well, it'd be interesting to watch this case progress, you know, worse and worse. You're a good test case to watch how diabetes progresses. And another guy said, you have a mental problem. You need to be on. In fact, they put me on medication. You'll need to be on medication. Antidepressant. You'll need to be on medication for years, your whole life. And then someone else said, you got to eat this restricted diet, you know, and it. And I had three or four little babies, and I mean, I thought I couldn't work.
Yeah.
And on commissions.
I remember, and fear was trying to hit me because I'm thinking,
yeah,
here we are with all these little children on commission sales, no savings.
Well, there wasn't any commission
money.
Sales because I wasn't going anywhere.
Right.
I couldn't
function. And so our finances were tight.
Yeah, it was bad.
And I thought, what's going on with my husband? He's not the person I know. And money's not here, what are we gonna do? And
So
I remember the night that I looked at you and I said, do you wanna live the rest of your life on antidepressants?
Yeah.
And you said no, and I took them and flushed them down the toilet.
Yeah.
I'm not saying that's the cure-all for everybody, but I did not wanna live like that. And I knew in my heart that was not the answer.
Well, they caused a problem. One night I took, these medications were causing me problems on top of my problem.
Exactly.
And they had to carry me out of a meeting one night.
All the side effects of all of these medications are horrible.
It wasn't good.
They're horrible. You know, you see an advertisement for something that'll cure a cold, and then it's got 10 life debilitating side effects.
Well, anyway, literally, I couldn't move one night taking this medicine. It had to carry me because it just did something to my muscles and nerves.
Right.
And so
it's
I had to get off the medication.
Like a muscle relaxant.
Yeah, I couldn't function. So life was not, it was very scary. Not good then.
Right, we were crying out to God.
I cried out
to
the Lord. And he began to help me. He encouraged me to find out who I was in Christ. And so I began to study who I was in Christ. I read the stories about how Jesus cast out the demons. Now, I did not know that I was dealing with a spirit. And that was the major revelation.
Infirmity.
Yeah.
Right.
Because they have names for everything. You know, doctors have names for everything. But I went to church one night and received prayer, and I was instantly set free of this weighty depression.
Right.
And I thought, wow, I'm healed. And we went out to a Pizza Hut afterwards, and I felt that same yuckiness, that same, come back on. And I didn't know it was a spirit. Now I do now. But I mean, back then, I thought, well, I thought I was healed. You know,
well, we learned to take authority because we saw it responded to prayer.
Well, that
so
was
we
the first time.
Stand,
and I thought, well,
fight.
Yeah, this thing responded to spiritual authority. And then maybe a week later, I was praying in the spirit and it lifted again. And that's when I realized, wait a minute, this is a spirit.
Mm-hmm.
And then God taught me how to deal with this spirit. He taught me how to do warfare with it. And it kind of surprised me because I think we think that the devil is kind of like, if you just whisper the name of Jesus, he kind of just, yarp, arp, arp, arp. He just kind of, you know, just takes off. But he's persistent. And so God had to teach me how to deal with him.
Right. And you had to know strong enough to stand in your authority.
Exactly.
To continue to resist him. And then the enemy flees.
And so I remember the night when God finally taught me how to deal with it. And I took authority over it and it left. I was so excited. I remember I called you up and said, Drenda, we've got to celebrate. I've learned something. We need to have Chinese. You know, so we have to go find a Chinese restaurant because that was our favorite. And so we went out, and from that day on then, I still had physical symptoms trying to hit me, but the torment of the spirit was not there. But my body was still recovering. And so we went out to Tulsa for a healing conference because my body was still out of whack.
And interesting enough, when the healing evangelist prayed for you, he didn't pray about healing at all.
No, he didn't.
He said, what are you called to do? Who are you? I want to know who you are and what you're called to do.
Yeah.
So the attack was against the call of God.
That was before I was called to pastor.
And so many times you're battling sickness, you're battling something in your body, your finances. It's because there's a call of God to stand strong and to minister something to others. And so you overcame that. We got prayer that night, and I remember you had a dream.
Well, I got prayer, and the anointing is very strong, but at the end of the service, after the end of the service, I still felt these symptoms, which surprised me. I thought, well, if I can't be healed in this kind of anointing, you know, why am I still sick? Mm-hmm. And God gave me a dream that night of Mark 11:24. Therefore, when you pray, believe that you receive and you shall have it. I remember telling you, Drenda, I had this scripture, and you said, well, that's Mark 11:24. And I saw it. Wait a minute. I had been going, wait a minute, am I healed? No, I still have symptoms. Am I healed? No, God is going to. It was all future tense. And God was getting my attention and said, no, you are healed because I said you're healed.
Right.
And then I saw it. I said, oh my goodness, I am healed. I'm not trying to get healed. So if I ever ate anything high in sugar, it almost threw me into a coma.
Right.
But there was a little root beer stand in that town. We went to school there. We thought, let's go down to that root beer stand. Right. I said, I'm going to get me some of that root beer. So I hadn't had something sweet
for months.
And
I remember thinking when you were getting that, wow, I know this is not a good thing, but I remember saying to you, I believe you're healed, Gary. And I was inside thinking, I
because
hope you know you're
that, healed.
Because
if I drank that, it would throw me almost into a coma.
Right.
So I got that big mug and I drank it and tasted it. Man, it was so good. And I said, give me a second one. I had two of those big root beer mugs, you know, and I've been healed ever since.
Yes, you have.
God taught me how to do that.
Yes, you have. And we went on from there to go from you being healed to our businesses prospering.
Yep. Out of
and
debt.
Then going into ministry to help others find healing and blessings in their finances,
that's
too.
Right. We come back, you're going to meet another gal who's been healed by the power of God. Her story is amazing. We'll be back in just a minute. Hi, I'm Gary Keesee, and you will never fulfill your destiny until you fix your money thing. Visit GaryKeesee.com and don't forget to hit the subscribe button below for more amazing weekly videos on fixing your money thing. And thanks for watching.